I don't think there's been anything more poorly done in this county than the way that vote was handled. It came up without any notification to the public. It came up during a reorganization meeting to bring up something as significant as that with hardly a word about the consequences of it. The board did not take note that pushing it back a year delays our reimbursements by the state and making them more equitable by 2 years is a thing of keeping the public out. The fact of the matter is they didn't want to deal with that in an election year. We need to take on whatever we need to take on in the time that is to be taken on for what's right for the citizens. That was a wrong vote, and the people who voted on it did it in a wrong way, and it was the wrong vote. We need to get that assessment done next year.
I don't have an in-depth knowledge of this. I know that at this point in time, with the property values having the property values fallen as far as they have, and my house is a good example. 2008, it was $165,000. Last year, it was $135,000. I lost $30,000 in value. I think reassessing as soon as possible with the values as low as they are probably would be preferable for our county, knowing that the state reimburses on county wealth, and I too would push for that.
I was here for the 2009 meeting. I was here in January, the organization meeting that brought this up. I was shocked when it happened, especially with the current representative of Beverly Manor voting against the property assessments in 2009 and then voting to extend them in 2010, or sorry, beginning in 2011. I've already said that I would immediately move to reassess the properties as quickly as possible. I've seen a lot of flyers as I've walked door to door, and it says in there in a nice big balloon, price below assessed value, as if that was something to talk about. The reality is our lands and our homes are all overpriced, and the board knew that in 2009 when they made their decision to stick with them, and the board knew that in 2011 that they were still falling, and they probably will continue to fall as we've seen in the press. So it's going to be important for us to stay on top of this. In terms of the tax rate, we would need to see where the assessments come in before we can talk about adjustments to that. Thank you.
With the reassessment, and I did vote against the reassessment in March 11th of 2009 on that. And with the property's values, it was in chaos. You had 2 years of property values that were increasing, followed by 2 years of property values decreasing. And the reassessment was right in the middle of that. And then this go around, I have a business that's directly related to real estate, and I can tell you that the real estate market between 2009 and 2010 was anything but stable. When you want a fair and accurate assessment, you want it done when the market is as stable as possible and the prices aren't moving all over the place. And that was one reason why I voted to extend the assessment for one more year, was to give that stabilization so that when we do the reassessment next year, the prices won't be all over the place and the reassessment can be as fair as we can possibly get. And as far as the tax increase for adjusting the tax rate, that's one thing that concerns me is we've seen Waynesboro with their property values that went up and with the where they actually had to do a tax increase also.
Okay, Mr. Carapa has asked for a rebuttal, so what the rule is it 30 seconds, is that correct? Okay.
With the market still being chaotic as it is, I'm wondering if the supervisor would again extend the assessment for the sixth year.
Opportunity for rebuttal, Mr. Shipley?
Yes. Would I extend it again for the sixth year? No. Today and this past week, I've spent time speaking with real estate agents, mortgage lenders and things, and they say that the market probably may possibly go a little bit further down, but they are seeing signs as long as Washington stays out of the way, and as one told me, screwing around with the mortgage industry on there, that we could probably see a steady, you know, stabilization of it over the next several years.
Nobody likes to pay no more taxes than they have to. I certainly don't. And I don't think it was done right either. And you have an appeal system, in which I went through that, and I didn't like the results either, but that's hindsight. But as far as redoing the assessments in 2012, I would say no, because everything is done by the Code of Virginia. And it's no use for the county to spend $500,000 doing these reassessments, then by law, we are required to do it in 2013. So if that's the way I understand it correctly, then you know, we have to look at it and follow the Code of Virginia and do the law. There was a bill down there this year to General Assembly that did not pass, and that was where the localities would have to prove to you on your assessments. Now the way it is, you have to prove to the Commissioner of Revenue on your assessment. It didn't pass. So we lost a big one there.
Mr. Commentator, can I?
Yeah, I'm ready for a little, Mr. Piles.
Yeah, Mr. Burris doesn't understand the law. We have to do it, and there was one other people made a statement that we have to do it every 4 years. The law's changed where we have to do it every 6 years. At the law, we could do it more often, but if we do it next year, then we've got 6 years again.
Let me answer that.
Mr. Yeah, Mr. Morris.
Well, Tracy, I didn't know I was running against you. I thought you was in the pastor's district. I mean, I know you're going down in the North River district putting signs up, but, you know, I don't understand why you're running for government.
This has to do with accurate information going out, and I don't want to be embarrassed and, you know, let that go out as a candidate that know what their law is.
You know, everyone knows I was a critic of the assessments written up in the newsletters, written up in News Virginian. And, you know, it's not about the assessed values, it's about the composite index. The reason why the state of Virginia mandates that we do this is because half of the composite index, 50% of it, is based off of real estate values. And then that's how they decide to give us money. So we're getting beat by Fairfax County, who does an assessment every single year, especially in a downturn. They got $65 million extra this year because they got poor when compared to us. What we need to do is we need to do the assessment. It's not an emotional, it's not a philosophical question, it's a cost-benefit analysis. Will we get more money from the state of Virginia by doing the property assessment? And right now I'd have to say yes. We do it, we spend the $500,000, and over the next 6 years, because we're locking it in at the lowest real estate value possible, we're going to get more and more money every year, and it's going to more than pay for itself, that $500,000. Thank you, Bruce.
I confess that that is something that I am not really aware of, but the thing I would promise is this, that I will study any issue and every issue in depth to make sure I understand it completely before I'll make a decision. That includes this decision as well.